Hey, Catherine. There's actually a limitation about arrays.
What do you mean? That's what you wanted us to use. What's wrong with it?
Well, I've been thinking about it, and there's actually a better data structure for us to store these words in case we want to add more to in the future.
What data structure is that?
Well, it's something called an ArrayList. And we can use these stackable boxes as an analogy. For example, if we want the ArrayList to shrink in size, we just remove elements from it. And if we want it to grow, we can just add elements onto it.
Okay, how big does it actually get?
Well, there's actually no upper limit to how big the ArrayList can get. Whereas with the array, once we create it, it's stuck that size.
Okay, so where do I put these? Because I want to put the strings 1, 2, and 3 in there.
Well, the first word can go in the first element.
Okay.
The second word can go in the second element.
Okay.
And the third word will go in the third element.
Okay. So can I put anything in an element of an ArrayList?
Well, we can't put anything. ArrayList can only hold object data types.
As opposed to?
Well, remember primitive data types? Things like integers, booleans, and floats.
But what if I want to store an integer in an element?
Well, it's kind of tricky. But in Java, we have something called object wrappers. They wrap around primitive data types to help them become object data types. So for example, we can store the capital I integer, but we can't store the lowercase I integer.
Oh, OK, I got it. So an ArrayList can hold object data types, not primitive types. It just seems like an ArrayList is a lot more flexible, because there's no wasted spots as compared to an array, which could have blank spots. So why not just always use an ArrayList?
Ooh, glad you asked. So I have this wonderful comparison chart that will answer all your questions.
OK, let's check it out.
Here's a table that compares and contrasts the array and the ArrayList. Like we mentioned earlier, an array cannot change size once it's created, whereas an ArrayList can change size. Now for the question, is it a class? An array is not a class. It doesn't have methods to access and modify elements. On the other hand, an ArrayList has a class definition. This means that every instance of an ArrayList is an object, which has methods we can use to access and modify the data. And so that's showcased here. And what each data structure can store is different as well. An array can contain primitive and object data types. However, an ArrayList can only contain object data types. So to help make this clear, let's look at some example scenarios in real Android apps. Within the Settings app, we have a Wi-Fi screen that shows the list of available Wi-Fi networks near you. In this case, we probably want to store this information in an ArrayList. And this is because the list of available Wi-Fi networks can grow or shrink, depending on where you're located. Sometimes, there are no Wi-Fi networks near you. And other times, there might be a ton. In this case, it doesn't make sense to have a fixed size array. In the YouTube app, there's a feature that can allow you to create a playlist of videos to watch later. And this is an ideal situation for an ArrayList because we'll continue to add videos that we want to see and remove those that we've already watched. And since we need the data structure to dynamically change in size, we should use an ArrayList. On the other hand, in the Alarm Clock app, we have a potential use case for an array. When you specify an alarm, you specify what day of the week the alarm should repeat on. This could be a Boolean array, which stores true if the alarm would happen on that day, and false if the alarm should not happen on that day. So there will only ever be 7 days in a week, so the size of our Boolean array won't need to change over time. Hence, we can use an array. Another possible use case for an array is the Google Play Store app. When searching for an app, you can view a list of categories which includes businesses, communication, education, apps, and more. If you scroll up and down, the number of categories in the Play Store will stay pretty fixed over time. So in this case, we'll use an array to store this information. Now to summarize, array and array lists are two different types of data structures that are ideal for different use cases. Arrays have a fixed size, while array lists have variable size. You can store objects and primitives in an array, while you can only store object types in an array list. Next, we'll dive in and see how to write code to create an array list.